Here we are at the sawmill. Raymond's the ambassador now, and he's showing the little kids.
But this is slow, but it's so much better than the past. Plenty of boys before you had the this one. And before you had this, there weren't any boards. And you ever see a log cabin?
Isabella.
Stacked up logs. Because they didn't have boards.
Do you guys know how did they bring it down the river?
No.
No?
He can tell you about that.
What's this now?
Bring the logs down the river.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah. And they sent them down a bunch. And you know, lots of them sunk. And they're now finding them and bringing them up, and they get a fortune for them. And Japan buys a lot of them, make furniture. But they've been in underwater maybe 100 years. And they salvage those. And
why didn't they rot when they were underwater?
Lack of oxygen. And the wood gets really deep. They make big conference tables out of them. Big, big money.
Yeah, I know.
Did you guys hear that?
Yeah.
Why they don't rot underwater, because they don't get no air.
Well, if somebody bought some property with a river through it, the things he got out of the water paid for the property.
Yeah.
But, the fellow that found that sawmill in New Jersey, that's almost 100 years old. It was, they say, 1930. That's when it was running. But it's almost 100 years old.
Are you starting up the diesel motor?
Brought it down.
Okay, it's going to get real noisy now.
Oh, yeah. When they wanted me to do this, I asked the guy to have a
talk.
You got some of those compared to the gear. He shut those down.
Ambassador now. Sawdust goes in a pile. Teaching little kids. Here we go. to do it later. Over here. So the sawdust comes off of the machine here. This is River Bend Park, Jupiter, Florida. Teaching little kids how things are done. That's enough for now.